for me. Oh, that was close one. I realized with like 25 seconds left to go that I had the incorrect teapot on my desk and that the one I had just made was still in the kitchen, and then had to like run and get it. And usually in 25 seconds I can make it to my kitchen and back no time, no problem at all. But I have like flappies tied to my legs and one of them falls down. It was kind of a tripping hazard, so sad. Oh, how you guys doing? What's this angle? Where do I sit? Where do I go? This isn't right. You mess with one thing and you'll never put it back. Close enough. Hi, everybody. How you doing? What's up? Bedding windows are open. Joker, Kira, fish plants. The day when nobody wants to cooperate with the pet cam, I just take a house plant, put it on a table, and put a webcam on it and say, watch my plant grow. And, you know, worse things have happened on the internet. Maybe Joker, Hazel didn't get a Twitch notification. Oh, Hazel, wow, and the Great British Baking Show, good, how are you? I am stellar. No, that's too much. I'm fine. That's more appropriate. So I'm excited because Ardenweald is on alpha. There's new alpha content, and I'm embarrassed that I had to find out by, opening up the Twitch pages. Every now and then, I don't necessarily spend a lot of time in any given stream, but I like to take a glance over the WoW front page just to be like, what are all the cool kids doing? What's everybody else doing? And they were all playing Ardenweald, and I'm like, oh, snap, there's alpha. So I have to play that, you know? I don't do a lot of alpha streams around here because... why don't I do many more alpha streams? I think I just don't feel like I have any specifically exciting insight to offer on alpha content, and after we've done it once, I'm like, well, that was that. But there's new stuff to do. I am specifically looking forward to this zone. This is kind of Ardenweald and the Night Fae are kind of, oh no, I lost my dog, tied with Revendreth and the Venthyr for my favorite kind of aesthetic vibe. So I'm very excited to see specifically how potentially creepy it could be. Let's get some game sound because I want to know what the soundtrack is like. Let's make sure that's coming through a little bit. Let's see here. We have Dusk. Thank you very much for the brand new sub. Welcome to the Scroll Squad. And Shells with the 12-month resub. Happy 1 year. Happy 12 months, Hazel. Anniversaries. Anniversaries everywhere. Okay. So I need to make a new template character. So we're going to select Ardenweald to create a character. What shall... Oh. There's nothing new about this. I don't know why I'm so surprised by him. What shall I create today? And how come it is a gnome priest? Oh. This... Are there new options on Alpha? Did they ever come out with those hairstyles? No, not yet. There's the two new hairstyles. I need to fix this face. I'm sorry, dear. You look wise, but you're scaring the children a little bit. Let's see. There we go. That's the appropriate amount of haven't slept lately. Teha, thank you for the 11-month reset. Appreciate it. Two hunters. Marksman's going to Revendreth, and BM is going to Ardenweald. Absolutely, that makes sense. Defo Druid gnome faces most of us before copping. Alright, let's see. Hairstyle. I do like the shadow the large bun. I'm not sure if I would switch to it from my normal ponytail, but this isn't really what we're testing on Alpha today, so I should probably keep it moving. I don't know if, let's go with teal eyes, it'll kind of match. That seems close enough. Let's see. Hazel. Glitter. You know, fairy vibes. Renee, thank you very much for the 2 month reset. Appreciate it. Do you have to opt into the alpha? So if you want to be in the list of people that can be chosen for alpha, yes, there is an opt-in. However, my understanding is that the current round of people that are in alpha have been selected as content creators. So people with, you know, podcasts and streams and YouTube channels and blogs, that kind of thing. Which of your alts are going to join the Night Fae? My... Night Elf Druid. Why am I lagging? Okay. My Night Elf Druid, because I'm not very original. That gnome hasn't had a mount drop in months. Ardenweald is the Night Elf Fairy Zone. So, first things first, how are my keybinds? Because I'm gonna need to, like, get around and live my life without being like, I don't know how to do damage. So let's make sure we have auto loot on. I'm going to pull up my... I have a little screenshot that I've saved. Ah, there it is. my Shadow Priest keybind, so I'm just gonna I'm just gonna fix this real quick. 1, 2, 3. I'm getting better at this. 4, 5, 6. And then we have that one on 9. That one goes on 12. There, there, there. We're gonna enable a couple of extra bars because I have not been on today. System. Interface. Action bars. Right, bottom. Right, 2. Sure, yeah. That one is mounting, so we can throw a mount over there. What else? There's Life Grip. Probably won't need that. Levitate. Probably will need that. And then we have Psychic Scream. Ooh, Nock, thank you very much for the 8-month reset. Appreciate it. Do you get to preview the Moth Mount? Don't know how Alpha works. Just curious, because that one is my favorite. I don't think so. So the mounts that I have access to on Alpha, they give you this gilded prowler, and by give, I just mean like they activate it for characters in Alpha. I'm certain that we're not going to get this easily when it comes out in live. But they just give that one to you to like get around in Alpha. And then I also have mounts that I had saved to my account last time I was in a Blizzard beta, just because I participated in the BFA beta as well, so it remembers the mounts that I had back then. But the actual, like the Ardenweald Moth, they've updated the names now. We have Ardenweald Moth Dark, but that one, not available to actually ride around just yet. Looks like Shadow Moon Valley. How much of the professions are active? Any glyph news? I did a video looking at the new profession items. I don't remember any specific glyphs, but they did add a couple of new items to Inscription. Crazy week. First Anax spawns, get the mount, then do the Obsidian Krolosk meta and grinded the White War Saber, then Molly, and now doing Bruce. That is a big, big mount week. Look at the pretty waterfall. Okay, I was finishing my keybinds. Let's see. We need silence on 5 because I want to get moving. I could live here all day doing my buttons, and I really shouldn't. Nobody needs that. We'll have this on 0. I don't mind control. I'm too lazy for that. I can barely control my own mind. And that can go on 6, that can go on 2. Alright, do we have any talents? They just gave us all of these ones, and honestly, that's probably fine. I usually live with Shadow Word Void, but it's cool. Hikanai, oh, that's not Hikanai, that's Hail Kanye. Well, thank you for the brand new sub. Welcome to the Squirrel Squad. I misread the L. Starting leveling a Nightborne Arcane Mage, and it's surprisingly a lot of fun. Nightborne Arcane. That's what my Nightborne is. Okay, so... hang on, I want more sound, because this is lovely. Let's do sound effects. Turn it up a little bit, for you guys. If it gets to be too loud, please let me know so I can turn it down. I don't have any audio monitoring on, so. I've always loved this color scheme. Ooh, somebody's got a unicorn pet. Okay. So, little fairy people, and you look like you need some water.
Well, well, what do we have here?
Can you guys hear that? What does bring you to Ardenweald? Oh yeah, I guess in the actual game we will have gone through Maldraxxus first. So we have a message from the Primus of Maldraxxus. I don't know what it says. What on earth is she saying? The queen doesn't have time for pranks, so she thinks I'm pranking her. Well, he and or she, hard to say. It was a very feminine voice, but I don't actually, I think that might be, I mean, we're not, it doesn't matter. This fairy thinks I'm pranking them. And we're going to
Never
assist
a dull
them.
Moment with you.
Oh. It's like a gnome voice if it got a little bit more twinkly, you know? Let's see. That wasn't creepy. They removed the timers and Torghast. Are you happy about that? I'm happy about nothing. I'm slowly dying inside and have no opinions whatsoever. Honestly, I didn't... Alright, that's too loud. I mean, I guess I can turn it back on and then just turn it down. I wasn't worried about it in the first place, so while I think it's probably overall a good thing that they're not proceeding with the timers, I think it's more of an optics thing than anything else. I had my doubts that they were ever going to be much of an impact on your everyday player. But, you know, I'm sure they can find other ways, and there were definitely other ways for them to accomplish the same goal, so this seems to be for the best. I don't know if happy is the right word, but again, emotions don't always come through. Alright, there you go. Have some flowers. I'm telling you, what you need here is water. This thing looks wilted. Ooh. What is it? Alright, so he's waking up. A beard, a hat, gifts of time, and mirth of fae. The forest sighs in laughter. Well, that makes no sense. Maybe they can help the forest grow again soon. Look at how long its arms are. This is some Slender Man stuff. Oh, boy. Alright. Where is Lady Moonberry? Oh, this is Lady Moonberry.
Oh,
you are a lady.
Should be interesting.
Or at least that's your name. Looks so cool. He needs some water. I've, as a person with great experience in neglecting house plants, that plant right there needs some love. It also looks like it could use some more light, which doesn't really surprise me. It seems to be very dark out here. It seems to be stretching, looking for light that it is not yet giving. So get that plant like a nice window today. Are we going to get past all four zones before being able to choose one? Yes, that is true. The first time that you play through level 50 to 60, the Shadowlands leveling zones, you're going to do all four of them in a specific and given order, and then you will, and then you get to choose your covenant. Subsequent times after that, when you're leveling your alts through, then you can choose your covenant right away and do the zones in any order you please. But the first time, we're going to do them in a specific order, and you don't choose your covenant until the end.
So nice.
Hang on.
To see
what's
you.
Happening over here? Stacked fae? Fairies? No, there's a word for these things. These are fae. I don't know. They're all pretty. They're all real cute. Ardenweald is on the brink. As usual, we're going to slay Mothbane the Mighty, who looks very tiny. I will seek out the queen on your behalf, Hazel Glitter. I could get used to this. Maybe Hazel Glitter needs to be a recurring name. Help my fellow Night Fae. Oh, yeah, that's right. They are Fae. They're Night Fae with their Spriggan problem. Boot their leader off that poor moth, and then Featherlight will tell you where to go next. All right.
I can't wait to see
Let's go find Mothbane the Mighty. Oh, this is Mothbane the Mighty. That's Mothbane the Mighty right there. Oh, goodness. Maybe Night Fae is my calling? How long did he start? Stream's only been up for 17 minutes, and honestly, that's surprising to me, because I do feel as though I just sat down. I haven't even poured my tea yet. When Shadowlands comes out, will you be leveling through a specific X-Pack more than others? Yes, in that I have a couple of routes that I will probably favor. Specifically, I'm curious to try out Draenor leveling from the get-go, because I've leveled through Draenor many times and haven't quested since VoD. So, and I remember the questing being kind of fun. So maybe Draenor, but also just the original zones. I feel like I could spend my entire leveling experience there just fine. The thing, though, is that, especially with the experience buff, I have, I need to turn the sound down. This is a lot. There we go. Let's, you know, dialogue can be up. Sound does not need to be. Oh, ghost unicorns. I'm gonna have a lot of alts already. I don't know how many characters I realistically need to level. Also, ow. just Shadow Priest things, don't mind me. Ferocious, thank you very much for the brand new sub. Welcome to the Squirrel Squad, appreciate it. Hope you're doing good. Ferocious TV, that's it. I might die. This may be the end for me. I think I didn't kill it fast enough. Let's try that again, shall we? What do you still have to level? Exactly, that's the thing. And to be fair, the question, what do you still have to level, has never stopped me before. I'm pretty content to continue leveling duplicates of classes just in different races, so I could do that. But I think I'm reaching a point where I really, like, I'm forgetting about alts. And I used to say, well, you know, I can always have more because I can use them for mount farms and whatnot, but I'm reaching a point where I don't have any patience to run more than about 10 to 12 characters through any given thing. Like, if I want to get, I could live a world where I have 50 alts or 49 or whatever, and I level, or I use all of them to farm Rust Feather every day, and I don't think I have enough time in a day to run 50 alts through Rust Feather. I can't even do it twice. Okay, I didn't take Mothbane the Mighty seriously. I looked at his
small stature and went, "How could you be Mothbane the Mighty?" And he smote me, and I did deserve it. So let's pop Shadow Fiend and offer Mothbane the respect that Mothbane deserves. And then if I see him casting that summon, Misty Allies. Yeah, we're going to fear that because that was bad. Those horses hurt. He's going to do it again, and I can silence, but it was too late. Whoops, a daisy do. Madamese, thank you very much for the 2-month resub. Good evening. A month all out. Ooh, ow, ooh, ow. Already. Thanks for the relaxing reprieve in these stressful times. Am I going to be okay? Are we? Okay. They don't despawn. Shadow. Okay. The thing about Priest is that sometimes you need to dig deep into your toolkit to discover the strength you need to survive a quest boss. You can handle the Spriggans. I don't know if I can. That was tough. Maybe I should pick a different class. No, I can't. This is who I am. Besides, what am I going to do? Boom. Good. Can handle some of the more interesting items in Lady Moonberry's agenda. I do enjoy saying Lady Moonberry. It's very fun to say. There's a request for help regarding an imperiled wild seed and something about an egg. Alright, so we're going to go help Corinth recover his wild seed. Nothing can possibly go wrong. Hazel has the baby dog. He's good. He's still an old man, but he's much chipper and seems to want to be back to normal. I let him talk me into a bit of a walk this morning. I've been letting him tell me whether or not he wants to go out, because I don't really want to like drag him out of bed if he doesn't want to get up. But he came to the door, and I took him outside, and I was just going to take him outside, take him back up, and then do my walk. But then he like wanted to go, and then he wanted to go a little further, and he was going at a pretty good clip, so I took him for a little short walk. Get his strength back up. I want to make sure that when I do start properly exercising him again, we kind of ease into it so that we don't throw out his hips, because I imagine he's lost a little bit of muscle. Okay, you, I hear, have lost some seeds, which are now sounding kind of like babies. Let's take a minute to observe this fashion. He's got like a corset situation. He's got some wonderful fur and very long nails and pretty pointy hooves and nice braids that do clip through his pecs, but maybe his pecs were just in the way. Digging the vibe, digging the shirt that comes just up to pec height but definitely does not cover them. That's a look. Okay, what's up? What happened to you? Why don't I understand? There is so little anima, I know that. We're out of that stuff. I've had to say goodbye to so many slumbering spirits. But Elder Dunmira is so close to her time of awakening I couldn't say goodbye like that. I moved her wild seed to a spot where I thought she could get a little more anima to make it through. That terrible creature stole it. I think the bird is trying to incubate it like an egg. Yeah, what's a wild seed? They're the purpose of Ardenweald. Wild seeds contain slumbering nature spirits, like Elder Dunmira. So I need to coax the bird off the nest to grab Elder Dunmira back, who is a slumbering spirit who, it sounds like they're gonna die, but like, aren't they already, is this not the place where we're already dead? I feel dumb. I'm glad Moonberry was able to send somebody. Let's see, get the bird off the nest. Yeah, well, I mean, are you gonna sing for me? Oh. He is gonna sing for me. Thank you. Okay. So we're hold still. Oh. All right, I'm bird. Let's see. We have strutting and singing. Am I flirting with this bird? I'm bird flirting. Well, let's get a little closer. You can't see me bird flirt. Yeah, like get a load of that. You ever seen one of those Planet Earth documentaries and those birds are just like, yeah. Yeah, that's right. Come on, come get some of this. Listen, I came all the way out here. I prepared this beautiful choreography. The least you could do is stand up. Yeah. Oh, I need to do more. Even though he is clearly off the nest because I'm just really good at this. I don't know what to say. I got bird game. This is a very strange quest. Am I at a range? No, no, it's working. Okay. Looks like he's got to have a headache. Lots of corsets in Shadowlands. Reminds me of Cats from the musical Cats. How is the Alpha? Is there anything like the Azurite neck? No, there's not. At least not that we've seen so far, and they did say they're not doing that this time. They mentioned that back at BlizzCon, they said that they're going to skip the whole Azurite slash artifact power expansion spanning grind this time around. However, ow! Everything hurts! We don't know yet what the pace of endgame progression is going to be like, because you are going to be like leveling up your soul binds, which is going to require anima, which is going to be some sort of progression process, but not this, not something that you're doing the whole expansion anyways. Okay. I did have that bird ready to build a nest and raise hatchlings. This is fun. Easier but less fun task. Oh no. So we're going to bring the list of saved wild seeds to another grove. I'm very confused as to what happens to the wild seeds when we don't save them, when they're already in the plant afterlife. Can they double die? This is an off-Broadway show. What are you looking forward to most in the Shadowlands so far? Is it basic of me to say that I'm really looking forward to, like, world questing in these zones? The zones are so, so pretty, and they're so, like, intricate, and they just feel like... In BFA, they made some really intricate, in-depth zones that felt like real places, but you had kind of the main two aesthetics. You had the Tirigard sound area, you know, what is it called? Kul-Tiras, and then you had Zandalar. And here we have four completely different and unique aesthetics, and I think the storytelling is going to be a little more concise too, because I know things happened in BFA, and I could probably reference some of them, but like everything in a list in order, I'm pretty lost. Okay, so a few of them will be cared for in Tir na Vaal. I don't know what's happening to the rest of them. They're going to double die. They were bad plants, maybe. They're going to plant Maw. Let's see. Helping some souls in trouble wasn't on the list. Let's go rescue some souls in peril. We may be missing some context for some story that has happened, because they send you to this zone after Maldraxxus, and as of yet on Alpha, we haven't had access to Maldraxxus yet. So it's possible that there's, you know, plot that I don't know. And it's also possible there's plot that I should have learned in Revendreth and or Bastion that I also didn't absorb, because I'm not very good at remembering story. Or reading it in the first place. I mostly look at the models and check out the systems and call it a day. Trinity Blade, thanks for the gift sub. Lag's not just me. Which lag? Stream lag? Let's see. Look forward once the Pathfinder grind is over. Can you see yourself doing these quests X10 for the alt heavy players? I mean, it's just leveling, right? Like, I'm sure, yeah. To some extent. I don't know how much of it you need to continue doing. Over and over again, I want to be whatever that quest giver is, the centaur man. Ooh, this guy? Let's take a look. So he has a face that confuses me, because, like, yeah. Four legs, quadrupedal. We have hooves, we have fur, we have armor, which is really cool. We love the weapon. And you look at the face, and he's got horns like a big goat. But then you look at his face, and, like... Is that not, like, more of a mammal face? Well, no, I guess they are mammals. There's something weird going on there. I don't quite understand. Is that what an antelope face looks like, though? Like, you'd think that his snout would be longer. It almost looks like a... Like a... I can't put my finger in what animal this almost looks like, but it's not something that usually has, like, deer legs. Anyways. That's a giant tree, not a skybox. Ooh... Oh, we haven't looked up yet. Look at all the glitter. Ugh. Oh, the colors are so pretty. It's so swirly. And then there's like more branch. Well, there's like more branch texture behind the big tree in the sky. But you also have like the big swirly branches and stuff. That's pretty cool. Looks more like a cat or something. Yeah, it's vaguely feline. I think you're right. A humanoid mouth with a cat nose. Any bets on if we'll be seeing cosplayers looking like that guy next BlizzCon? I mean, that's a big costume to do. You might see him, but it might be an on stage only. I don't know if you could walk around the convention looking like that. Okay. Who are you? You are a big sparkly puppy. He's a soul. It's called the Ardenweald. How do you like my soul-shaped form? I always wanted to run around as a wolf all the time. Well, you got it. What happened? We were attacked by starving wildlife. That's no good. What class did you main prior to Shadow Priest? What made you want to change? I didn't really main anything prior to Shadow Priest. I was a chronic alt switcher. From Wrath when I started all the way through to the end of MOP, I would just pick a new class every 6 months or 4 months or whatever, often on a new server and level completely over from scratch. I did tend to bounce between usually Beastmaster, Hunter, Holy Priest, Druids of some kind, although I did have a pretty good stint as a Destrolock, but I also kind of dabbled in almost everything else too. I spent basically all of MOP. I played for the entire expansion of Mists of Pandaria. I did not raid. I did not do PvP. And all I did was level alts. That was the whole thing. I just leveled alts for the whole expansion. Fashion. Wow. You got like a belt. You got like a cute bodice thing. You got some bracers. You got a cute little ponytail. You're not wearing pants. I guess she's furry. She's fine. it's unclear what modesty looks like to a Night Fae. I was trying to take the souls to a place to give their anima. It all went wrong. The wildlife of Ardenweald were never so dangerous. Okay. I mean, I'll try to help you, but I'm very squishy. I don't know if I'm going to be much good. Can't decide on a main. Want to know everyone's favorites and why. Why am I a Shadow Priest? Everything else feels wrong. Alright, so I need to rescue 3 nature spirits and also Chufa. Hunter, Druid, and whatever else on long occasions. Darkwinds, thank you very much for the 10-month resub. Thank you, Hazel, for great content. Aw, shucks. Want that wolf form, my shaman? It's very, bright. It appears to be smoking and I guess sparking's not quite the right word, but sparkling is also not quite the right word. It's like, it's raving. Alright, I need to make my way kind of that way. I'm gonna do this very slowly and carefully and just do one mob at a time. I'm probably gonna not worry too much about dotting them up. I think that between Mind Blast and Void Bolts and whatnot, we can just pretend that we're not a dot class because nothing should live long enough to matter. Dots are a trap. Dots are a trap to make you think you should cast them, and the answer is no, you shouldn't. Okay. Yeah, this is working much better. Also, these don't seem as hard to fight. These are only level 54, which is a little unusual. I am currently scaled to level 55. Based on the level ranges we've seen so far, you would level through... Well, actually, that's curious. I was going to say... Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so you would level through Bastion, and then Maldraxxus, and then here, and then Revendreth is the last one, because you start Revendreth at level 57. Alright, so Chufa was a squirrel. Oh my god. You know? Oh. Alright, who else needs help? I'm pretty much capped. I'm pretty maxed. That squirrel's nuts. You're not using Shadow Word Void? ? No, just because they gave me far left talent straight down the board when I logged in. I have not yet been to a rest area, and I'm too lazy to pop a tome. Void is probably better. What does it want? I guess it wants Fortress of the Mind, which is just going to give me more Mind Blast damage, which is also fine. I usually will run Void on live, though, for sure. Okay, make sure to let Moonberry know of your heroic rescue in her name. She might even decide she owes you a favor. She seems fun. So we get some bracers. Learn those. Put those on. Alright, continue down the road towards Tir Naval. Everything on the list. Okay. Which I'm kind of excited to see. I've heard so much about it by now. It looks like it's not very far. It's just 140 yards down the road. Is this the new Pepe? Oh, I don't have the head squirrel anymore. I didn't bring him very far. I feel like he probably could have walked. Oh, what's up? Oh. Don't cry. You look so cute. You've matched your dress to your horns. Just, oh, I'm sorry. Oh, what's up? Oh, her granny is sick. Why do I feel like I'm about to get scammed. Just by the roadway, this feels suspicious. Am I just heartless? Her and her granny were trying to go to Tir na Vala. We were hoping the Droman could help us. So weak and the forest is so dangerous. Please, would you help me? My granny's hiding in a cave nearby and she's so sick. Of course. I'm... and Dunes, thank you very much for the 8-month resub. Another month, it's almost being born. Monica plays WoW. Thank you very much for the brand new sub. Welcome to the Squirrel Squad. They are tricksters. You know what it is? Is I know it's like many years too late for this, but we just started watching Better Call Saul. And there's a variety of various scams that you get to see in the first season of that show. And I think that's why that's on my mind. I hope we get them as an allied race. Don't go into that cave. All right. Oh, here's Granny. She's barely breathing. She's just flat on her face in the middle of a cave. She has a lovely bag there. That's cute. One eye is wide open staring at you. The mouth stretches open into a gaping maw. My, what big teeth you have. Listen, I called it. You know what the takeaway is here? Trust no one. Never trust anybody. Never let them in. Never tell them what you really think. Knox having the time of his life. He's oozed off the camera. Ow, 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 ow. Oh boy, I can't start reading chat while I'm fighting things. I need to devote 100% of my mental attention to any given... Oh, you know what it is? I'm not buffed. I need to devote all of my attention to any quest boss I decide to fight. Wow. Oh, I just keep forgetting. You're just a little squishy. This is very typical for cloth classes when they're leveling, particularly priest, because it's not like you're a mage that can kind of kite, or a warlock that has like a pet to tank for you. You just kind of have to like have them punch you. What's the big idea? Oh, I see. Oh, it wasn't a Night Fae after all. It was three tricksters standing on top of each other. And now I have a feeling they're gonna wreck me because there's three of them. I guess they don't have that much health. Oh boy. All right. Feels bad, man. Joker, I love. Anyone keep disconnecting in retail? The tricksters in a trench coat. They had a very convincing illusion. Ow, 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 ow. You know what I'm really grateful for in this exact particular moment is that screen blink effect that they added in when you're about to die. When I first did that, I'm like, well, duh, I know I'm about to die. You don't have to gloat about it, game. But, you know, it's nice for seeing out of the corner of my eye when I'm, like, kind of looking at chat. And I'm like, oh, no, things are going horribly wrong over here. Let's see. Not bothering me much. Your WoW seems to be stuttering. Seems to happen on a lot of movement lately. Yeah. This happens sometimes when I'm streaming alpha. It's, let me look at my task manager. I bet you my GPU is capping out again. This was happening to me pretty recently. Let's see. Yeah, that's what it is. The good news is I know what's happening. The bad news is I don't know how to fix it. I can downscale. I could stop the stream and restart it and see if that helps, but, what I'm gonna do for now. Let's, turn the graphics down just for now. We're gonna turn anything that's not important, like, pretty far down. We'll take medium particles. It's not that my graphics card cannot support streaming WoW, it's that, between alpha being not necessarily quite optimized yet, and sometimes my OBS decides to go a little ham on the GPU, sometimes things can get a little crazy, so we'll turn view distance down, ground clutter all the way off, detail can stay at like 5, spell density is fine, textures, we want to keep that, and we'll keep the resolutions on, so let's turn things down a little bit. And see if that helps. I'll also say, the other thing I want to do actually, system advanced. We want to cap our foreground FPS to 60 because there's really no point in running it at 90 FPS. I hope I can do this without having to turn down my resolution. There we go. All right, so that might help. 73, 71, 68. Yeah, that should be better. All right, I wonder if the alpha update changed my settings or if I just never did that. Possible I never did it. Hi, what's up everybody? A lot better. Yeah, I had to do that on live at some point. I thought it was my graphics card drivers, but I've updated those pretty recently. Hazel, may I ask a question? Go for it. The answer to that is almost always, like, you can always ask your question. Depending on what it is, I may or may not answer it. I usually don't get too overly personal on the stream. But I also don't read every message just because it's hard to see all of them sometimes. And it would be a real shame if the only one I saw was, can I ask a question? You're welcome to ask that, but there's a non-zero chance that I see that one and then miss your actual question. Let's see, you got Corinth to do the dance. Let's see, express your appreciation for her help. Well, of course. Okay, so what's that? What are we doing next? Every leaf eventually dies. Even in the afterlife, some trees remain evergreen in reminder of spring. It's fine on my end, and I'm in Ireland. Our Wi-Fi is powered by potatoes. For a moment, Workskin, I thought you said that your wife was powered by potatoes, which I guess is quite plausible. You could have a wife, and she could have a diet where a fair amount of her calories comes from potatoes. They are a staple food. The ripple of time stretch across an eternal sea. Well, you don't speak straight, do you? Let's see. Souls most attuned to nature come to Ardenweald for their rest. Those not to be reborn play in the forest. Oh, I see. Everybody else gets spat back out into the real world. Gotcha. To the north, these souls do not rest. They have fallen into danger, okay? Oh no, not Chufa again. My squirrel buddy. Oh, my squad. All right. The Song of Tirnaval is discordant. Speak with the Dreamweaver. There's chaos in the area. What else is new? It's probably my fault. I feel like everywhere I go in WoW, there's always chaos. When I went to Pandaria, it was literally because of me. So maybe I'm the problem here. Maybe what WoW needs is for me as a gnome to just stay home in Stormwind and like play with my cats. Oh. Hazel, how are you today, St. Marcus? I am doing pretty well. I'm doing pretty well. I am enjoying the new zone so far. It's very pretty. That's all it takes to make me happy, is make it very pretty and don't make it completely broken. I haven't disconnected yet. Spirits of the Glen or Dreamer. Oh no, I could go two different directions. That one's closer, but this is fine. Hang on, Spirits of the Glen. I want to save Chufa for last. Well, oh no, they're both campaign quests, so we're gonna have to do both of them. I don't want to abandon Chufa, but I'm looking forward to that one more, so I want to save that for last, like dessert. Boil them, mash them, stick them in a stew. Just got into streaming, looking into small Bluetooth earphones like yours. Do you have any recommendations? So, I would say not these, because one of mine died, and or just won't connect, and they've been kind of finicky. These are the Anchor Soundcore ones. And aside from the fact that one of them died, they've been mostly fine, but they came with like six different sets of tips and none of them fit for me, although everybody's ears are different. And I haven't tried any other ones. It depends on whether or not you want a single ear, like you want separate earbuds, because if you can get into just headphones, that opens up a lot more options. And then the other thing that's important to remember is that I am not using any headphone of mine for the microphone because I'm using a separate microphone. If you are going to be streaming into the microphone of your headset, that's a different consideration. Okay. We're attending to some wild seeds. We're collecting baskets of anima cones and then using them on seeds. And we're going to slay some anima-starved wildlife. I'm glad that the initial conflict is nice and easy to understand. It's very central. Each of the four zones are experiencing anima shortages, and the anima shortages are because Sylvanas is cartoon villain stealing all of it. That's my understanding. Directing it all to the Maw, something along those lines. And that makes sense, you know? Every design you get to, they've all got problems, and you can pretty much figure out the gist of it. I managed to get Molly today, my second super try, super lucky. Hi, congrats, Baggy. Any change to the shadow form in Shadowlands? Any glyph to remove it? I want to see my transmog. So there is a glyph to remove it on live. Well, not remove it, but to make it less opaque. I have used that glyph in the past on my Shadow Priest. I think it's just called the Glyph of Shadow. I don't see any visible, noticeable changes. I am not currently using the glyph on Shadowlands, and I don't have access to it handy, so I can't see if they've changed it. I would be surprised. My eyes do look kind of spooky. Like, my eye light seems to be, unhidden by my shadow form. I don't know if that's always been true. It's a little creepy. It's a little blink, blink, you know, from old cartoons where you'd have, like, just eye glow in darkness as though... I mean, I guess if it's a cat's eye... A cat's eye will continue to glow in the dark, but or just reflect very small trace lights from the environment. However, I think like a regular human eye probably would not show up unless there's some light to be reflecting off of it. Okay, there we go. Tried those earbuds, never had any issues with them. Yeah, it's possible it's my fault too. I can't in good conscience recommend them given that I've had them once and they definitely did not. You know, the right one works. If you only want to wear the right earbud, then you're cool. It's just when you want both of them. I just set up my boom mic, definitely can look more into it. Wonder who replaces Sylvanas as war chief. My understanding is that there's going to be some kind of a council situation. Saw your video about the level squish. The timed sections where you hover over the play bar are very cool. Love your vids. Keep it up. Why, thank you. So that is a new YouTube feature they just rolled out called Chapters, where if I provide timestamps in the description, it will break the video up into various chapters so people can kind of see what's available and jump to various sections that are of interest to them. And I'm really excited about that because that's super, super applicable to my content. I make nothing but big lists. I am incapable of talking about one thing for longer than like 3 minutes at a time. So even my like Saturday news videos, you'll hit a couple of topics and that way I can kind of have the breakup visible so people can, like, if they're not interested in one particular piece of news, they can just skip to the next one. Seems pretty good. Marcus, thank you very much for the brand new sub. Welcome to the Squirrel Squad. I appreciate the flattery. I disagree. I look nothing like Kate Blanchett. That's a very nice thing to say, though. Let's see. If every story told on Earth actually happened in a different universe, including WoW, and the creators of these stories lived the stories, you're on some different stuff over there. Have you tried the hard reset? Put them both in the case, hold both buttons till they flash red. Yeah, I guess I can give it a go. I haven't done that with these, no. I was messing with Bluetooth recently. Oh yeah, it was when I was trying to get wireless headphones to work with my television. I wanted to play Animal Crossing with wireless headphones on the TV because I fish by listening in Animal Crossing. I cannot fish by looking. I get too jumpy and I'll press the button too early. But if I listen for the sploosh instead of the splish, then I can fish effectively. But the problem is that the TV's in the living room and it's an open area and there's like noise pollution, there's noise from outside, and my husband's desk is in the same area, so if he's gaming and he's on his keyboard, there's a little bit of extra sound going on that I will sometimes mistake for a fish sound, and I'll just get, I can't fish like that because I'm a diva. So what I wanted was headphones that would work with it, but the TV's pretty far, so I wanted to, and I have wireless headphones, so I ended up getting this adapter and I got this transmitter, and I got it finally set up and hooked up and working with the headphones, and then I realized I'm dumb. And the latency on the Bluetooth is too much to effectively fish in Animal Crossing because there is very little room for mistake. You need to be very quick on the button when you hear the sound. And if there's any delay at all in the sound, and there's fairly considerable delay on the Bluetooth because the headphones that I have were not compatible with the Bluetooth protocol that reduced latency. I don't remember what it's called, but the transmitter would do it, but the headphones wouldn't. And I refused to buy a sixth pair of headphones for something that's still going to have latency and still will probably not let me catch like the rare fish quickly enough. Because it only really matters when you're trying to catch a really rare fish. And that's when you want to catch it, you know? So I gave up. And now I'm just sad. Actually, now I don't really, I've kind of put down Animal Crossing for now. I got back into doing WoW dailies every day and I didn't really have time for both. Samamon, thank you very much for the 2 month reset. Love your YouTube vids, Hazel. Thank you. Boss Gods and YouTube are really good. Cheers. Pupster is off cam a bit now. Yeah, I wonder if, am I zoomed? Did I ever zoom in on that one? I wonder if I can just zoom back out, configure. Nope, that's it. Max, well, actually, You know what I think I can do? There you go. That'll do it. One more piece of wildlife. Will there be a Pathfinder for Shadowlands? As I understand it, that is the plan. We haven't seen it. Actually, have we seen it yet? Let's see. Pathfinder. They did say they were gonna, though. Battle for Azeroth Pathfinder. Yeah, not in the achievement journal yet, but I imagine it's probably coming. Black magic, sleepy baby, Ardenweald hype. It's pretty so far. Also, I found a squirrel and he is now my friend. I don't get attached to questing NPCs too much, I failed to form an emotional attachment to Runus the Shamed. He had lovely voice acting. It was an interesting story, but I didn't cry every time. And I think that what it takes for me to really, you know, get invested emotionally in a questing story is there just has to be a squirrel or a cat. Any quest that has me rescue a cat from a building, which, to be fair, does not happen that often. I think I'm actually thinking of a different game, but I'm usually pretty into that cat. Can you imagine if they eventually find Jennifer and the solution is that she was just on a building somewhere, you know, disguised under a different name or something so people didn't just find it, but like all of the food was just to distract people. All of the little Karazhan stuff, they just put in a bunch of clues that didn't do anything, and the cat's just on like in a tree somewhere that just needs help. Oh, they wouldn't, but oh, it would be so funny. All right, mean, but also funny. Let's see. But they won't, because it's mean, but a little funny. Recover 25 anima cones from gobbling blossoms, of course. And then free some wild seed tenders from devouring hydra. That's going to give us a spirit tenders cord. Sleepy doggo, wish we could have one. Husband doesn't want any more pets. We have two cats already. I'm on the fence about... So I love my dog, and I hope we get many more years with him. We were a little scared for a while, but he seems to be doing good. But I am really on the fence about after, if I ever want another dog. I used to think I would always have a dog. I grew up with a pet dog, and I do enjoy, like, exercising with dogs, walking with dogs, whatnot. But maybe it's just that this one has such limiting, like, life-limiting anxiety that we can't do a lot of things because of. That has kind of put me off the whole idea. Or maybe it's just because he sheds a lot, which is very cute. It just, it's a lot. I clean an awful lot. You vacuum the place, and this is not a very big apartment, and you have to empty the canister probably 5 to 9 times within just vacuuming just the 2-bedroom place every week. If you do it twice a week, you can get away with emptying it only 4 times. He just generates endless additional dogs, except that they're less cute and they're all over your clothes. And I feel like it would be a little easier to do things like maybe get somebody to house sit while you travel, or like go to the store or something with if I lived in a life where I didn't have a dog. And I can probably get exercise independently. Plus, there's a bunch of places that you can hike around here that are just, you're not allowed to bring pets. Like, we kept, for a while, I was taking us to different popular hiking spots around Portland, and we kept showing up and there was no dogs allowed signs, you know, to preserve wildlife and whatnot. And we just have to turn around and go find a park where we could bring our on-leash dog. And there's not as many options. So, I love him a lot. I don't know if I'll get another dog. I'm on the fence about it. Fish are so much quieter, and my cat doesn't shed as much, you know? Roombas are a must for pet life. I don't know if the cat would survive a Roomba. She hates the vacuum. The vacuum is her mortal and sworn enemy. Oh, I have not been freeing Tendras from Hydras. And then she also, or not her, but we have, this is more a me problem than a Roomba problem, but we have loose Ethernet cables traversing our floor at a variety of points in our apartment. And I'm pretty sure that would be no bueno, no good. I trip over them all the time, so often I've been like, man, I should write this along a wall, or like pin it down or something, or like run it under the carpet, but I kind of like don't own this place, and I'm not confident enough in my abilities to run it under the carpet without just ruining the carpet. And I also haven't been able to find a solution that'll pin it to the ground without just like having like nails or other sharp things that I just know are gonna get like pulled out, and then somebody's gonna step on them or the dog's gonna step on them, and it's just not worth it. So we just trip over the cable. I still don't know. Carve through, so we kill the Hydra and then we carve up its dead body to free a fairy that, oh, there's a few of them in there. That can't smell good. Cats often ride around in the Roomba. Don't know if that would work out for mine. Dillstone, thank you very much for the 4-month reset. Appreciate it. One of our cats is double-coated, needs assistance with shedding her winter coat, having zero teeth with which to pull out clumps of fur. Waiting for the zone out of all of them. Can't wait to try it out tonight. It's pretty cool. It's It's pretty cool so far. Have you seen those furless sphinx cats? They're oddly adorable. I have seen them. I think I would need to meet one for it to be oddly adorable, because you see one and you're like, who let that thing out of hell? But then I think that the charm of the hairless cats comes from seeing them behave like a cat, which is cute. But when I've only ever seen them in still photos, it does look like something from a horror game. I think that I would need to meet one, perhaps, see what it's like to pet one. Car Hydra. Circus car full of clowns, but it's fairies. Cats hate the vacuum, don't mind the Roomba. If you have hardwood floors, no, there's no hardwood floors. There's carpet, and then there's more carpet, and then there's more carpet, and there's like a little bit of lino in the kitchen. And the bathroom, I guess. Let's see. Tuck them under the baseboard. What do you mean? Under the baseboard? The baseboard goes all the way to the base. I've done enough damage to this poor rental apartment. When we eventually leave this place, I already have extra plaster because I've just punched a fair few holes in the walls from hanging various posters and wall hangs and canvases and whatnot. I've done some real damage hanging the curtains because I learned some good lessons about hanging curtains from there. I've mostly learned that when the world gives you wall anchors, use them. But I'm gonna have enough damage without having to figure out how to get something under a baseboard. It really doesn't look like there's any gap underneath it. It looks like the carpet is above the baseboard level. Wanted to follow you for a while, but been busy with work lately. Really appreciate your content. Oh, thank you. They make wire shields that lay over top of your wires, stick to carpet. So I was looking into the Velcro ones at some point. I don't know if it would help with the Roomba problem, but it might help with the tripping hazard problem, because I really do almost eat it. Not every day, but probably about once a week, maybe. I've looked into the Velcro ones before. I just never buy them. I guess I'll have to die first. And then I'll be like, oh, I need this. Well, my husband will be. He'll probably find somebody to sue first. And then we'll realize that we need them because somebody died. But until then, you know, I feel like that's one hazard that, you know, something bad has to happen first. Because, like, what if it was, I don't know, it's going to be like $16 whole. Did you get the ivory drake? Oh, the cloud serpent? No, I haven't tried again yet. I have not, oh boy, this looks like it's going to hurt. I've not yet had a moment in my day where I was like, you know what I need is more disappointment. It's coming though. Ow. Never forget that you can always just scream and that does work. What's up next for the baking stream? It's posted in the Discord. I'm kidding. We're doing donuts, chocolate donuts, on Thursday, June 18th. So not next week, but the following week on a Thursday afternoon, we're going to do some donuts. It occurred to me that I have made these before. It occurred to me after I made the poll, but we did do these before, last year or the year before, something like that. But at the time, I didn't have a mini donut tin, because who does? And I just made them in the bottom of a muffin tin instead. And they were good, but they were basically kind of like brownies. And I've decided that if I'm going to do them again, I can't do the same lazy mistake again. So I actually ordered a silicone mini donut mold. And I spent longer than one should need to, trying to identify the correct circumference of a mini donut. Because some of them are micro donuts, and they're like little bitty bitty, and those I feel like I would have a hard time nailing down the bake time for. Plus, I'm not looking for a, you know, pebble. I'm looking for a mini donut, and then full size donuts are of course too big. So it turns out, for all you fact seekers out there, 1.75 inches is the standard mini donut size. There is some variation depending on the brand that is making the tin or the brand that is making the mini donuts, but basically you want 2 inches or a little under in order to have that mini donut experience that we're all after. Oh, one more, come on, one more. Yeah, there we go. Would you ever do a charity stream? I've done them. I'm better at doing them when I can join into an existing one. We did that one with Twitch. We played against Pajira for Doctors Without Borders. That VOD is still on my stream. I haven't independently organized any yet because I'm not very good at logistics. And that's the kind of thing that you really don't want to do wrong. So I have not independently organized any events, but anytime I can join into an existing campaign, those are always good. Try to twist one of the donuts, since Chogol has two heads. Twist it like into a like an eight, like an infinity sign. They're too small. You can use them as cereal. Chogol's Cho Choco Cocoa Puffs. That's hard to say. Chogol's Cho Choco Cocoa Puffs. All right, that's gonna be a belt. I should make sure I'm putting on this gear that I get. And did I ever get? I already put on the bracers. Good. Spirit Tender stuff. What is this set? Is this a Night Face set that we're getting, or are they just giving us the search? What do you mean search is not available? What do you mean? Okay. That's fine. I was gonna see if the rest of the set looked more Night Fae or more Bastion, you know, Kyrian, but it's fine. Alright, get the anima cones, go with the Dream River to feed some anima. But I need to go help Chufa. Alright, we'll finish this first. I was in a raid earlier, somebody mentioned your raid guides. Bit of shock because I only just started following you and watching you. I think the Zoom Noodle Assault is over though. Oh, true, yeah. Well, is it? Oh, true, yeah, no, it is. That's true. Do you know Raid Lock at Share still works? Just try the 130th time for Invincible. Do you know that it still works? I have heard from people farming it pretty recently. The latest update that I heard is that you can still do it, as I imagine you know, if you just did it for the 130th time. Speaking of which, my condolences. That's a long grind. I hope you get it soon. But you just have to accept your own invite. You have to log back and forth over to accept your own group finder invite. All right. Isn't this a great little wild seed? It'll be many years before it returns to its plane. Go on, take the anima cones you found, infuse it with anima. We'll hear its real name echo in the chamber. How exciting. Who's got bets that this is Ysera? Eventually. Anima cone used. Fold one of them. That could be tasty. Not sure. You guys just made me think of, there's lots of, like, folding and manipulating when you're doing bagels. And now I just kind of want to make bagels. I'm a little hungry. I had a piece of toast right before the stream started because I figured I was gonna need a little extra food, but I'm still a teeny tiny bit hungry. We did bagels on stream once, I feel like. Maybe not. Bagels get very messy whenever I make them because you're basically dipping your dough into a big pot of boiling water that also has baking soda in it and also some other stuff. There's like a syrup thing? I don't know. But it's messy because the water kind of splatters, and because it's not just water, but it's like baking soda water, everything it splatters on gets this little white mark on it, and it's just a nightmare to clean up afterwards, but they're so good. Where do you get that shirt? This was BlizzCon merch from last year. This was BlizzCon 2019 merch. Wild Seed Soothed. Oh, it's Raven. Just came across your stream, was super happy, I have something to watch while I level. medicated waifu. Cream cheese salmon bagel. Stop it. I'm hungry now. Deciding what to eat for dinner. Yo, so apparently today is the day that I've been anxiously waiting for that I thought wasn't going to happen until the weekend, but apparently it's going to be today where my air fryer is going to be delivered. So I think I have to try that today. Depending on how long it takes me to learn it, you know, there are some kitchen appliances. Also, it got really quiet. Where's the game sound? Are you looping music? Okay. There are some appliances where I feel it is best to not try to learn them while hungry because the extra pressure of you trying to create food now may lead you to make some mistakes in the operation of said project and give you a bad first impression or product, you know, item. So depending on how hard it is, I may or may not use it for dinner tonight. Green Duct Tape, thank you for the 9-month resub. Thanks for 9 months of delightful content. See the new Druid customization? No. I am curious. Are they ever going to finish this? Maybe not. Maybe they just have to work on it for a while. Oh yeah, that's true. We have to go tell the Droman about what happened here. I bet you that's Ysera though. They're making too big of a deal out of it. Highly recommend ramen. Oh, you just signed a new apartment celebrating with ramen and highly recommending ramen. Congratulations. I think I might do sushi tonight. I did the sweet potato sandwich thing last night and I have these sweet, oh no, I don't want to enter Torghast. I have these sweet potatoes that last time I went shopping, they were out of the normal sweet potatoes, but they had these, like, football, and I'm not exaggerating, football-sized sweet potatoes. And I bought them because I figured, okay. I needed an axe to chop through it, and I did not have an axe, so I had to kind of hack away at it for a while with a regular, fairly dull kitchen knife. One day, when I turn into a real grown-up, I'm going to learn how to sharpen knives. But I'm not there yet. I'm not ready to purchase knife sharpening apparatus. And I don't think that I am coordinationally qualified to practice sharpening knives. I feel like I will absolutely injure myself doing that, so I need to do that. Oh, look at the little buddy. He's back. What's up, buddy? Later in my life, when I finally learn how to control all of my limbs. What's this? What's this? The tall tree has sent you to help us? Oh, he repeats himself a lot. They need to calm down. What's this? What's that? What's anything? I love him. Nasty Spriggans, they came to the grove. They messed it all up. They took the anima from the soul webs. We were collecting it. Yes, collecting it for the tall tree in their grove. The Spriggans have to pay. Beat them up. And then use this soul web to take back the anima. We need it. They don't. Okay, we stan. What an icon. We need it. They don't. Defeat Spriggans. Use the soul web to drain them of stolen anima. Obviously. What else do you have to say? Oh no. Oh no. My friends, they gave so much of their anima. They lost their forms. Oh, so you're probably a person that just looks like a squirrel. We take a form when we come here. You see something that suits us. We give up our anima to help the groves. We give so much that sometimes it's too much. Still have some anima. Get me to my friends. We can get their forms back. So we're going to help Slanknin, Ruri, and Awul in the Spirit Glen. This is the best zone. Anonymous gift, thanks for the gift sub. Chifa doesn't mess around. Do they have the music for Revendreth up yet in the alpha? I don't know. Honestly, I haven't really heard a lot of music here in Ardenweald, so I would imagine not. But I haven't been back to check. If you get a ceramic knife, you never have to sharpen it. Yeah, but then I can break it. And that will happen. That 100% will happen. It's always stones. I love nature so much. Please sway me back to the Kyrians. I can't have the struggle of choice. Just go back and look at the armor sets again. The Kyrians had some very nice armor sets. Although, depending, the plate and the leather Night Fae armor sets were some of my favorites. The male one didn't really change my life. Oh, I needed to use the web because these Spriggans stole that anima. We need it. They don't. End of story. Taking that back. What about this thing? This is a Boggart. We are in Harry Potter now. We're literally a Harry Potter Boggart. I mean, I guess they probably existed before Harry Potter, but you know. I know them from Professor Lupin's class. Witcher music works great for this zone. What do you think of the new quest icon symbol? I'm not really sold on the new look. I like it well enough. It's a change that I don't think I needed, but I think will help ease new players into the game by making it harder to miss. It's visually easier to see because it has more contrast. It stands out a little bit more. So I think that we're going to get used to it and it'll probably be a good thing overall. It's not changing my life, but I like it well enough. Chufa said, catch these hits. Butcher, get you a good steel to keep your edge. If you want to go in deeper, you can get a 3-stage whetstone. I don't know any of those words. Get you a good steel to keep your edge. If you want to go deeper, you can get a 3-stage whetstone. I think I understand the basics of what you mean. My problem is that I need to practice knife sharpening on cheap knives because I don't want to ruin good knives by sharpening them before I figured out what I'm doing. And I have a little knife sharpener that is like a cheap one to use my cheap knives, and I would never use it on a good knife because it's basically one of those things that just has like a little divot that you just draw the knife through. It's got like one metal one for coarse sharpening and then a plastic end for fine sharpening, and it kind of does this. It does the job for like one meal because I sharpen my knives before I make sushi, because otherwise you just like shred the stuff while you're trying to slice it, and it's a real, I don't know. I don't have a lot of kitchen storage in particular, and I try to be very discerning with what kind of things I'm going to own in store that I will only use once or twice a year. Kitchen's. Kitchen's got a really good video on how to sharpen knives that makes it seem accessible. I've watched that channel before. I should check that out. Steel is a knife sharpener. Those are horrible. I'm sure it is, but it's doing the job well enough on my, like, $6 kitchen knife from Target. It definitely does shred it down, though. The thing's getting skinnier and skinnier, but that's fine because it's $6 from Target. And also, I think probably a good 6-7 years old. I still should do just fine. It's basically just a steel stick. Okay. Chufa better watch out. Might tame him on my hunter. I mean, Chufa might tame you. Okay. We should not have talked so much about food. I am going to get just hangrier and hangrier throughout the rest of the stream. I don't usually. I think I moved my keybind a little bit for vampiric embrace, which sometimes you need. Okay. Soul whip, come on, give it back. There we go. We just need two more. I think I probably forgot to use the item on a couple of them because I will never remember to do. I've been playing this game for how long? And anytime they have a quest that they're like, "Hey, use this item on the fallen corpse of an enemy," it's too much for me. One step too many. And they're definitely sticking with this type of quest. They've put some of them in the new player zone in Exile's Reach. They have tutorial quests that show you exactly how to do that. So it's not going anywhere. I'm gonna have to learn how to do it. Talking about knives, I'm cutting watermelon. What mount is that? This is the Gilded Prowler. It's a Shadowlands mount that they give us in Alpha. I don't think that we know yet how we're going to get it when it goes on live. But presumably something Kyrian. Oh, we don't like Spriggans. Okay. I never did help out Slanknin, Ruri, and Aul. An $8 kitchen supply store utility slash paring knife will last you nearly forever. How much should I expect to pay for a sharpening steel? Because if it's really just like a metal stick thing, or a stone stick thing, or whatever, what have you, I think I can probably fit that in my kitchen drawer along with my, like the chopsticks and the straws and whatnot. It will probably fit in that space. Oh, there's, you hear that sound? Great. I just wouldn't want to overpay or underpay. I think some things you shouldn't cheap out on. I don't know if that's one of them. Spray can sound like bad news. I wonder what the very first use this item on the dead body quest was. I imagine they were in vanilla. That doesn't sound like a new concept. Maybe not. This world quest is broken. Put a link in Discord. Okay. Sharpening steel is only used to reform the edge of the knife. It doesn't sharpen. I'm a knife noob. Stone is going to sharpen. The steel is just for readjusting the edge. Okay, so I want the stone and not the steel. The steel sounds like it's for people that know more than me. I just need to slice tomatoes without obliterating them, you know? Is that a Covenant mount? Again, unclear. Let's see if they have any more information on it. Gilded Prowler. Unparalleled apex predator of Bastion, this mighty Larian has trained since birth to carry its rider across the Shadowlands. So, hard maybe. Although, so if you look at, the placeholder mounts that they've added in. They have a lot more of them now, actually. Look, they've got a lot more colors. Phalanxes seem to be something that you'll actually, like, train the zone. There was, like, some quests that... I don't think those are necessarily the Covenant mounts, although they could be. The Phalanx could be the Kyrian Covenant mount. It seems like the Gargans are going to be the Venthyr ones. You've got Shadehounds, you've got Skullboards, you've got Torlus. I think that's the Maldraxian one, and then... Rune stags appear to be the other one, so I feel like this is probably something else. If this turned out to be my Kyrian class mount, I think I would be disappointed because it's a little too reminiscent of, like, the Winged Guardian. It's not original enough to be a very exciting, like, Covenant mount, rather. Not class mount, Covenant mount. I need to get in this tree. I've been here before. I've had this problem before. Steel is good to prolong the edge, keep the sharpness a bit longer, so I would get both. I don't know why I'm so reluctant to buy both at once. I feel like I want to tailor the amount of stuff I'm buying to my current skill level. Like how I would probably purchase gym clothes and go for a run before I decided to purchase, like, workout equipment, you know, like, ease into it. Because, well, I guess, you know, I'm more likely to quit working out than I am to quit sharpening my knives, because I'm always going to need to, like, cook. Buy pre-sliced chopped veggies, five head. Yo, so I bought pre-chopped carrots because there was a man in front of the non-chopped carrots, and I didn't want to ask him to move. Mood, right? And the pre-chopped carrots, they were, like, crinkle cut, like chips. Like, they wanted you to be like, hey, these are like chips, eat them like chips, but they're like 100% carrots. And I'm like, well, that's fun. You know, they're already cut into, like, small sizes. I do eat them as snacks, and this way, if I'm doing, if I'm doing, like, a stir fry or something, I can just shake some into the pan and be on my way. It'll save me some time. And you know what? Some of those crinkle-cut carrot pieces were so tough that they were, like, woodsy. Like, you would chew them, and you would chew them, and you would chew them, and then you would basically pull a piece of chewed wood out of your mouth that was definitely not food. Because it was just, like, from a carrot that was so mutant and so gigantic that it had grown a tree in the middle. Or something along that those lines. And I no longer trust that particular bag of crinkle-cut carrots. I do enjoy buying pre-cut frozen broccoli, because when I buy heads of broccoli, I feel like I throw out so much of it anyways, because I really only want the florets. And if I can just buy the florets frozen, it's really cheap around here. It's like less than $3 for a bag of frozen broccoli, and it's so easy to just throw that in the pan. And I want to see if the air fryer is going to ruin them, or if that'll actually be good, because that could mean I could do it for lunch. What is your... Oh, hang on. Illusory saber fang. Can I just dispel you? I thought you were an illusion. What are you hiding? Old Legion jokes. Slice tomatoes, use a steak knife. So, you guys might judge me for this. I only have 3 knives. And 2 of them are both chef's knives. I only have a double chef's knife because a company sent me one once, which was very strange. But I did take it because I was like, yeah, I'll use a knife. Sure. So I have 2 chef's knives and I have a bread knife, a serrated bread knife. And that's it. No steak knives, no paring knives, no... what else? What else would you have? Stabbing knives. I have a tea pick. Solo Singer, thank you very much for the 6-month reset. Appreciate it. Also, 6-foot pro with a brand new sub. Welcome to the Squirrel Squad. And I believe I missed one from Crixies. Again, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Welcome to the Squirrel Squad. Ow, goodness gracious. Golly gee, I'm dying. There we go. Oh, we found Owl. He's my favorite. When I was a kid, my cousins and I would play on my grandparents' property. There was, like, a bunch of cousins, and the game, which I don't know if it was a real game that other people played or if it was just something that one of the kids made up, but it was called Awuga, and essentially the rules is that everybody would run around and somebody would yell Awuga as loud as they could. And I think that was the whole game. I don't remember if there was more to the game. I don't remember if you were trying to find the person who was yelling. I think maybe it was just fun. All right, there's Awul. Oh, he's an owl. Again. Oh, thank you, Chufa. Oh. That one hurts a little bit. All right, I found my friends. They have their forms. Now we have one last thing to do. One last thing. What's up? Bad, Spriggans? Bad. That one is worst of all. Mizuki tells the others what to do, and he rides a Gorm. Big, nasty Gorm. Get him, get him. Chufa was definitely a gnome in Chufa's past life. All right, I'm gonna need to use cooldowns. Oh boy, I'm gonna need to use cooldowns now.
What is it now?
I'm gonna actually fear them, and then get a couple dots out while they're far, and then wait until. Oh no, that can't happen sometimes. Wait until they get closer to Void Erupt, and we're gonna use our Empiric Embrace. Man, I was hoping I would be able to save some cooldowns for the quest boss, because I'm gonna need them. Poik, thank you very much for the 3-month resub. How have I still got a sub? I mean, I don't know. You don't have to. Favorite succulent? Jade plants. Jade plants. I had a dream, actually, last night that I was walking around my grandmother's house, and visiting all of her plants that had once inspired me, because the reason I like jade plants so much is because my grandmother has like a really big one, like a tree-sized jade plant, and it's just gorgeous and I really like that, so that's why I like them. But in my dream, she also had like a 12-foot monstera plant. I'm like, how did I not remember this? And my mom's like, yeah, Nana's got like plant game. And then we both learned how to meld into walls. You just had to lean against the wall and like believe. It was a long dream. That is not how you play Aug. How dare children have fun. To be fair, it was a very large property. So while I'm sure we disturbed some neighbors, they wouldn't have been very close. I don't care about the new mounts. For 12 years, I only use my big blizzard bear from BlizzCon 2008 as a ground mount. I don't even have that one. Sometimes you're such a dude. Were things I do myself that I used to feel weird and guilty for. We're all cool. We're all people. We're all just getting by. I recorded the office tour today, and I've been editing it. And I edit myself all the time. I edit myself for the news videos. If I'm like editing together a stream VOD, I'll see myself. But usually in those videos, I'm sitting on a chair. I'm not moving too much. I don't see myself from other angles. And something about seeing myself like walk around and move in space and be visibly uncomfortable makes me wonder, am I good? Am I good? There's something a little off about me when viewed from camera. Maybe it's just because I'm very uncomfortable looking at myself on camera, and because I get to edit out all of the awkward takes so that I have to have those burned into my memory forever. But sometimes I feel as though I'm either not all here or just here in a slightly different way. I don't know. I guess, you know what my problem is that I have had so little social exposure, like in-person social exposure, not just because of the quarantine, but in general over the last 5 years, that the only thing I can compare myself to are other people as I see them on the internet, where they're also editing themselves. So either I am a little off and that's just okay, or I'm just like everybody else, but I haven't seen other people in real life for years, so I've forgotten that everybody else is a little weird too. I feel like I don't stand right. My Charmed Life, thank you very much for the 5-month reset, appreciate it. Let's see, I have that mount, office tour hype. There's no cat in the tour. Both the cat and the dog slept right through it. I'm considering going back to pick up extra footage just to shove in it somewhere, because it is a little disappointing. Bad Spriggan's gone. Now to leave, we have to leave. Don't leave, you're my favorite. To the tree. It's time to return to the grove. We have the anima, we have our forms. Tall Tree needs the anima. Tall Tree will be happy. We gotta make Tall Tree happy. All right, back we go. We're all a little off, I think. Whenever I see my reflection, it's like, ah! Who's that guy? Don't know if that's a good thing, but it's the thing. Ever think of moving? Often, yeah. I feel like we can't possibly rent this place until the end of our lives. We've already lived here longer than we kind of thought we would. I feel like originally we moved in, and that was probably 5 years ago. And we said we would eventually save up and buy a house. And it's just, it's never quite... That always seems like a step that for one reason or another we're never quite ready to make, but we also don't really have any compelling reason to move, and it's easier to just kind of stay here. And we like this place well enough. It's got a lot going for it. There's a lot to be said for this apartment.
Oh,
Ardenweald Covenant ability. So we just kind of keep staying here and not making any changes. Really helped get Tyr Naval ready for the Winter Queen's arrival. Won't regret her decision. Let's see. I can't have you meet the Winter Queen without some of Ardenweald's essence. So we gotta retrieve Ardenweald's essence from Lady Moonberry. Alright, so we're gonna get our Covenant ability, which means surround myself with helpful sprites, causing my next 10 spellcasts to aid my target. So my Shadow Mend and Mind Blast will reduce an ally's damage taken. Void Bolt will reduce the cooldowns of up to 5 allies' major abilities. So the thing about the Night and Fae Covenant ability is that it's helpful. It's an ally buff. You're not really... I mean, maybe it works in yourself if you're alone, but generally speaking, you're helping your friends, which is why it's something I want to take in a healer, not necessarily on my DPS character. Congrats on the 3 mounts in one day. Hope you are liking Alpha. Have a great day.
Well, Thanks.
All right, let's try that out. So, was it a... I'm ready to be properly prepared. Hang on. I want to know, do I need to put that on my bar? Is it a passive? Is it all the time? I didn't get a button. All right, we're going to be properly prepared to meet the Winter Queen. What's happening to me? Oh! Here, I'll take my shadow form off so we can see what's going on.
Are you going to turn me into a fairy? Can I be a squirrel?
I look so smug. I love gnomes. Look at that. Oh, I love her so much. Oh, no.
They're running away from the Heartwood Grove. Something is wrong.
Shocking. Shadow Heels, thanks for the 3-month resub. Thank you for the hilarious streams. Do you know how the level crunch will affect soloing dungeons for mounts and such? I did a video testing it out. The short answer is it won't really. The dungeons are getting squished along with us. So short of a couple of bugs they need to iron out, like legacy loot mode not being active, everything seems like it's going to be mostly fine. If anything, it's going to be a bit easier. Once you get to level 60, get some gear on you, it's going to be easier to run old content than it has been in the past. Something wrong in my Shadowlands? It's more likely than you think. Oh, I can't get over this thing. It's so droopy. It's so tired looking. I just want to give it a nap. And also, it keeps saying things like, the ripples of time stretch across an eternal sea. It's like that friend in high school that just thinks they're a philosopher. They write poetry and they won't let anyone read it. Which, I mean, fair, but they're going to tell you about the poetry that they're writing that they won't let you read. You know, if you're going to write secret poetry, do it in secret. great conflict drowning the already sorrowful song of Heartwood Grove. Okay, so now I get the button. There we go. So it's a 1.5 minute cooldown. That's what I wanted to know. Good. Okay. So off we go on a stag. Where's my mount? There it is. Hello. Oh, you're cute. Although I feel like you need a mane. You're a little... I mean, I don't want to say bald, but... Ah! You had fairy wings when you floated, you missed it? This looks awesome. I loved Ardenweald at the first glance, now I just love it even more. This might be my favorite zone so far, although I did love Revendreth also. Maybe I wasn't in the right- Oh, look at the baby deer! Look at the baby deer, buddy! It's too far, you really looked at it, but they're really cute! Love this map, this zone's gorgeous. Yeah, I do like this one. I don't think I would take it on my Shadow Priest. And I don't know that I would necessarily take it on a Holy Priest. I feel like if I was going to play Holy, I would probably go Kyrian, just because I really like the Kyrian Cloth Mog for a healer. It's just, this is my Rested Druid Covenant for sure. Alright, design for Shadowlands is on point. Yeah, I mean, that team has always crushed it, but this is really, really cool. Let's see, you took my friends, my grove, and my wild seeds. I will never join you. So we've got to go save Heartwood Grove from stuff and reasons. Oh, the ardent moss are withering. This whole area looks a little dry. Have they tried watering? Speaking of which, this is not a story really, but before the stream, I had a bit of a struggle. I was out on my balcony and I have several plants out there. One of them is a maple tree, a Japanese maple tree. It's in a pot and I keep the pot on top of a plastic tray thing so that when I water it, it doesn't drip water down on my poor downstairs neighbors. But the thing is, I guess I watered it too heavily. Like that, it's been in that pot for a long time and that soil no longer really holds water. It wasn't very good soil to begin with. I keep needing to repot it. I just never remember. So a lot of the water that I gave to it yesterday ended up in the tray and it was still soaking in water. And usually when that happens, you want to get rid of the water. So what I do is I like grab a bucket and I take the bucket outside and then you like lift the plant out of the water, but then it was like pouring water out of the bottom of it because it was like really wet. So I didn't want to just like put it on the deck and have it like again drip water down. So I decided I was going to put the plant in the bucket and then pour the rest of the water around the plant because there's like a little lip because it's like a car washing bucket. I was going to pour the rest of the water into the bottom of the bucket kind of around the plant. So then I could just like pull the plant out when it was done draining. Maybe squeeze it a little bit and then put it back in the deck and be good. But then, so I put the plant in the bucket and I pour the water in the bucket and then I go to pull the plant out of the bucket and the plant's stuck in the bucket. Why anybody watches a stream? I don't know. But I can't just like you know, plant a foot in the bottom of the bucket and give it a good yank, because the bottom of the bucket's filled with water. What a terrible predicament. I eventually ended up being able to kind of finagle it out of there, and then I only spilled a moderate amount of water and then brought the rest of it in to dump it out. I discovered that I have a bucket that is almost exactly the same size as the bottom of the pot that plant is in. I need to be recovering some withering wild seeds. I'm always afraid whenever I'm not getting quest credit done on everything that there's something I need to do that I'm not doing. Okay, I gotta loot that seed. Ow, 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 ow. No reading chat for you. You're fighting three things at once. Who do you think you are? Some kind of not shadow priest? I wonder, I should probably finish that thing. Sometimes, you know, when a mob has like, drat, blast, gosh darn it. You know when a mob has like one health point and you're like, I put a shadower paint on that, it'll probably die. No, no, no. That's not the way. Evening, Squirrel Squad. Good evening, Softy. Bang bucket. I used to own only the one bucket. And I guess I functionally still do. I ended up purchasing additional buckets for aquarium water changes, but the thing about a fish bucket is that is for fish and only fish. You never put anything else in that bucket, and you never use that bucket for anything else. It's plastic is porous and will absorb things such as cleaners or other contaminants, and you really, really, really don't want that getting back into water for fish. So once a fish bucket, always a fish bucket. I buy specific red ones for that, and then I have like a marker on the side of it to mark which one it is. I know it's behind me. There's a big hill. I think I ran past the entrance, actually. How did I get up there the first time? It was from the other side, yeah? Well, maybe, actually, you know, maybe there's a way up over here. Hazel, is your Volpera gonna join the Night Fae too? My Volpera is still level 20. We haven't leveled her. Let's see, great looking zone. We had a bag of cat litter burst on our porch, raining cat product on our downstairs porch. Oh no. Apology gift card at the door. Still can feel kind of bad about it. I mean, if they had anything that had been spilled down there, then that would have made it easier to clean up. Maybe, I don't know. At the gas station, we used to keep bags of cat litter so that anytime there was a gas spill, you would pour the cat litter on the gas bill to help absorb it so that you could dispose of it. And it was always on hand for that reason. So, you know, big stretch, but something. Let's put the dog bed. Once upon a time, there was a dog in there, and or cat. Neither one of them appeared to be interested in sitting on a bed that's in range of me. So it's just an empty bed, you know. What is an empty pet bed but relaxation that has yet to happen? It's potential. It's future cuddles. It's the rest that shall come after you accomplish what is in front of you today. One of these days I'm going to run out of things to say, and it will probably be well after I should have stopped talking. Oh, hey, the dog's going back. Oh, the dog's getting bribed to go back. Look at that. Magic. Always wonder, watch your YouTube videos, never caught a stream before. Welcome, Xandors. I like the spell effect that goes whoosh all over the place. If you do the questing now in Alpha, won't it be spoiled or boring to do while leveling in live? Maybe. If anything, though, I think for me, I greatly benefit from doing questing at least once on Alpha, or at least before the game comes out, because I need to see a quest a number of times before I really learn it, and I'm getting all of my wandering around not accomplishing anything out of the way, in theory. I'm figuring out what I'm doing. Oh no, Corinth! The heart is gone, it was taken to the Shrouded Mire. Go, go, go. Droman had a mask. They took the heart to the Shrouded Mire. Please get it back. Okay. I finally got my hands in the priest toy or a thing from Light's Hope Chapel. Can I see your macro for the continuous uptime of it or have it posted somewhere? I'm not logged in right now. You just macro it into something. Like anything that you do pretty often, it's not going to be continuous uptime because it's got a 10-minute cooldown on a 5-minute duration. But like any spell that you use all the time, I think I have it macroed into like my dot or maybe my Voiderept. But you can basically take any spell at all and then type slash cast that spell, and then slash use Thaumaturgus Orb, or whatever it's called. As long as it's spelled correctly, that should work. I don't have it handy now because I'm not on retail, or else I would pull it up for you. Started doing islands. How long did it take you to get the albatross? I ground out the albatross pre-doubloon buff, honestly, so it took me quite a while, but it should be much easier to get now. They've made it so that you can get doubloons at a pretty quick rate, like 18 to 25 of them per run if you're just cranking out. Mythic Islands is the way to go. Just get a good group together, scrape together like maybe a tank and a pair of DPS that can do some good AoE, and you will be flying through mythics and getting a good handful of doubloons each time. It should be pretty good. Speaking of islands, there is the Skittering Hollow? Question mark? Cash on the vendor this week? There's a box that I want to buy for the Craghorn Chasm Leaper. So I'd like to do some more islands this week, I think, on stream. Magic third hand, bribing Joker into the bed. It's slash cast Thaumaturge's Orb, because toys are spells, apparently. Mm. Yeah, I guess that would make sense. Yeah, because items are used, right? And then it's spell. How do you know anything about the BOE... Oh, sorry. Do you know anything about the BOE Legion Legendaries in Shadowlands? Do I know anything about the BOE Legion Legendaries in Shadowlands? No. Well, okay. So, I think I'm being thrown off by the presence of the word Legion. Just, I know, I think I understand where you're getting at with that, but just for clarity's sake, I have no understanding that the Legion Legendaries from Legion will have any play in Shadowlands, nor will they become BOE. However, in Shadowlands, there is a new legendary system that involves crafting and basically customizing your own legendary. This is going to involve crafting professions, and it is going to involve Torghast. You are going to run Torghast to get legendary components, combine those with some manner of item which does appear to be crafted by a crafter, but probably sellable, to put together your own legendary. I don't know if that legendary becomes BOE and you're able to sell the work that you did in Torghast, or if it's just the base components. Some of those are buyable, and then the item, once you have made it, is soulbound. I don't know the specifics. To my knowledge, that's not in on Alpha yet. The last time I saw in Torghast, the bosses were dropping placeholder legendary components, but you were not able to do anything with them yet at the time. Perhaps that's changed and I missed it. Eldrin Tournament mounts should count towards collection meta. I don't see any reason why they wouldn't. I don't think professions have anything to do with legendaries. There's items in the journals, though. If I don't have any professions on this character, but if here, we'll take a look at it. I will log out because I have another character that is a mage, so she can like port to the various people and train it. Because I am kind of curious to see if there's anything more in the journal. I don't think it's going to require you to have the profession, but it may. You may need to buy a thing from somebody that does. And then the materials for them. I don't think we had too many details last time, but let's take a look. So let's get on the mage. She's in Stormwind. Bath time for Joker. Do you guys have dogs that do that? That kind of like lick themselves? I don't know if he's grooming or if it's just an anxiety thing, because he also licks his bed. Okay, so she has tailoring presently. If we look at the unlearned Shadowlands materials, you have a craftsman pouch. It's an optional regent. Makes crafted armor. Have a chance to give an additional skill point when crafting items from the Shadowlands. Interesting. Okay. Modified regent. Still not done yet. Grimveiled stuff. They have optional regent slots. I did do a video on the new items that kind of talk about how this works. It looks like it's a little bit more specific now. You can guarantee both secondary stats if you get the items for them. That's neat. So what am I thinking? That's a lot of gear. Create a piece of cloth armor that is worthy of becoming infused with the power necessary to become a legendary item. So you have Grimveiled every armor slot. Belt, bracers, cape, hood, mittens, pants, robes, sandals, and spalders. It takes 100 shrouded cloth, 2 enchanted lightless silk. Possible that you, entirely possible that there's going to be more. That might be a placeholder material requirement. They're just trying to say it's going to take a lot of stuff. and then one optional regent slot for item level specifically. But yeah, you'll be able to build a bear your own legendaries, and that will require items that are crafted by professions. This does not mean that in order to get your cloth legendaries, you will have to be a tailor. I imagine that these will be able to be sold. They do say bind on equip, bind when equipped, so you will be able to sell those. But yeah, that's what we know so far. Other professions also have stuff like that. I had a cat that demanded to lick my nail file. Oh, dear. I mean, I guess if it's a glass nail file, then you would be able to sterilize it. But like, if you're talking like a cardboard emery board, that will never be clean again. that will never be okay again. Goodness. Right now on live, you can earn the Awakening Essences from Legion and buy legendaries for your alt. You can equip them at 101. Oh, was wondering if those would scale or if they aren't in the game anymore. How would I find that out? Yeah, you get the Awakening Essence and buy legendaries. You can equip them 101. So I can't copy any. You know what I'm going to do is I'm going to port to, well, can I? I can do Stormwind or Orgrimmar presently. Let's go to check on the portals. If I can get to Legion Dalaran, I want to go check on the vendor to see what the tooltips look like. The other thing that you can do is you can go to beta.wowhead.com to look through the Shadowlands item database and see what looking up a Legion legendary looks like when done on that site. That's the other option. Oh, a cat's tongue feels like a nail file. Oh, is that what you said? Or no? No, demanded to lick my nail file. Dogs do it. Akitas and other dogs with longer double-layered coats generally self-groom like cats do. Interesting. Yeah, no, I know where the vendor is. I'm not sure that I'll be able to get there. So we can port to Asuna, so we should be able to fly there then, actually. I don't know where you train portals in Stormwind, honestly. I went to train portals in Ironforge once upon a time. And that did work, but then I, like, couldn't get back there. Anyways, we can just fly from Asuna. Because they don't start you off with a Dalaran Hearthstone. My cat licks plastic bags, oh dear. Could be either the classic nail file or the metal ones. I'd find him licking them, have to take them away. That's so strange. Maybe he wants to eat you, and the closest that he can realistically get is consuming the tiny bits of dead skin that are on your nail file, and he's just doing that to tide him over until the day when he can one day consume you for real. This is Alpha. I was wondering how. Speaking of nail files, though, y'all tried those glass nail files? It's pretty good. Although, I was told that a glass nail file would effectively never dull, and I don't know if that's true. Maybe the one I got wasn't a good enough glass nail file, but I feel like it's already kind of losing its effectiveness, and I haven't had it that long. But it does, it definitely doesn't shred my nails quite the same way the old ones used to. Cheaper ones, super dull? Okay. Yeah, that's true. I didn't spend too much on it. I got it for like 10 bucks on Amazon. Cat likes to lick the tiny overlap area between plastic lids and paper cups on takeout treats. Cats are so weird, man. I feel like every cat has one or two things that are just like phenomenally strange about them. Every cat owner has like one thing that they'll tell you that you're like, wait, what? Your cat does what? There's, you know, they're all so different. My good one broke years ago. I haven't been able to find another since. Always thought that the glass nail file never dulling thing was a myth. I mean, theoretically, if assuming that, I guess maybe it depends on your technique as well, but if the glass is harder than your nail, then, and it's, as long as the raised edge, or not the raised edge, but like the grid on it doesn't just fall off, then you should be fine. Okay, I'm here in Legion Dalaran. Oh man. Or maybe you do just need to replace them. I feel like I'll still get a good chunk of use out of it just by rotating the various edges. So it's, is he upstairs, downstairs? It's been a while. This guy, hello. What brings you here? Let me browse your goods. So currently, bind to Blizzard account legendary items, item level 56. So that is not level 56, that's item level 56. I am currently item level 120, And I assume by the time you get to level 16 into some gear, you're going to be like kind of 200 plus. So it looks like they are still in the game. It seems they don't say that they require a given specific. Let's see. Oh, okay. So the actual item is item level 125. Wow. What? Okay. So the effects are inactive. Legacy item effects are inactive. So it's basically just a piece of gear. Did they always have the effects turned off? I thought they turned off artifact weapons but left these alone. Because the item level is better, yeah? It says requires level 40. It does say requires level 40, you're right. It's got a lot of stuff on it. Yeah. Requires level 40, item level 56, active now till 109. Okay. Oh, that's right. Okay. So, the question is, if I got one of these and send them to a level 40 character. So I guess the thing is, how long is it going to be active? Because you can't put it on until 40. And it's probably going to turn off before 50. So you're getting it for like a 10 level stretch, which doesn't really seem worth it. But it might be. One of my friends has a cat that is perfect for a Zoom call.
Good luck, friend.
A tuxedo on top and no pants. I see. What are the most alliance and the most horde populated servers? That isn't there data out there for that? Oh no, Realm Pop's gone, isn't it? There's some of them. I know some of the bigger ones. I don't know if I know the biggest ones off the top of my head. Where is Shadowlands on the map? Can you show us? Shadowlands is gone. I mean, it's the afterlife. I guess it's in Northrend, right? Is that a thing? No, it's not. It's just, you click on Azeroth. I don't have a button here, but it's in the drop-down menu. It's literally the afterlife. You can't, like, ride a boat there, you know? So, and then you have, they're all just kind of listed as floating in the world. Stormrage for Alliance, Area 52 for Horde. Probably get a new world icon to click to get to Shadowlands. That would make sense. I would agree. A good guide for collecting all tailoring recipes. I imagine somebody has like a write-up on either a blog or like a Wowhead post or something. Would be your best bet for that. But like all tailoring recipes, like front to back? That's a pretty niche thing. There's no real specific in-game reason to do that, to get everything, unless it's just completionism. You might be better off just kind of looking up recipes one by one as you see them in your list, because in your journal, you'll have your list of unlearned recipes. So you can see anything that you don't have from there, and then it should have a little bit of information about where to get it, but then you could look it up for more knowledge. Probably, let's see. Do you like Ouroboros? I do. I haven't spent a lot of time there. Honestly, last time I went there, I started serially disconnecting. So I haven't done a full walkthrough, but it seemed nice enough. It seemed nice and calm. It was a bit indoors. I was hoping for a more open air concept to it, especially given that it didn't have to be inside. Goodness gracious, you guys hurt me. Ouchie. But it seems nice. Wow, progress has realm pops. Okay. Try to get some sleep. On call in 5 hours. Thank you for the stream. See you later, Metapunk. Is it tough to play beta for so long knowing you can't keep your accomplishments? I think that's part of the reason why I pretty much only play beta for content. And don't get me wrong. I will absolutely report any bugs I see in the process of doing that. I typically do a good chunk of questing and will, do some typical testing as well. But if I'm not here to get information for a video or, you know, to play on stream, I'm not really playing it on my own for fun, because you don't get to keep this stuff. And I'm not somebody that's ever, I have never felt a personal deep need to see something before it's done. If I was not a content creator, I would be happy as a clam to just kind of let them work on it and not follow news too closely and then just play it whenever it came out and form my own opinions then. But I pay a little closer attention than that just because that's the job that I have chosen to decide to do. The one problem with going on the most popular, with rolling on the most populated realms is that once in a blue moon, I guess they don't really do this on Modern that much, but whenever there's like a crazy expansion launch or event or something, those realms are always the only ones to get hit with realm queues. Although I suppose that technology's come a long way. They can squeeze a lot of people on these days. Okay, the Groves Dorman. Pardon me, Droman. I keep seeing that and hearing Dorman. I'm wondering how to tell what the current corrupted zone is. There should be a marker on your map. I wonder if it's in Alpha, actually. If you are mousing over... Where am I going? So right now, there's always going to be one in Oldman, always one in Pandaria. And by clicking on the map, I can see that this one is the main Black Empire one. And then if I click on Oldham, I can see that this is the... It's outlined in purple on the map, essentially. This is the Amethet invasion. A glitchy bug now for reporting bugs. Holding it for taming undead pets, though? Oh, that would be cool. Yeah, how come undead hunters start with, like, a spider? What's up with that? Are there not there are undead animals. We have lots of undead models. We have undead battle pets for days. Where are all of the undead hunter pets? There are a couple models, right? Like, there's, you know, you got, like, the boar that has, like, the patches on it. Maybe it's just plagued. You know, maybe just need some skin treatments. Cover anima cones from the possessed. What do you think is going to happen with Ian and the Shadowlands content reveal thing on June 9th? I don't know. And if I did know, I couldn't say. But I don't know, so I can't say. Shadowlands stuff. Aren't hunters starting pets relative to their starting area? Undead has a spider cave. It does. But you know what else the undead area has? Is a lot of undead. You cannot tame what is not living. How come you can't tame a druid? I mean, there is a storyline. Or not a storyline, but in the Underbog, you have that boss dude that tamed some druids. Right? And you have to rescue them by defeating him because he tamed a bear druid that is, like, an actual druid. That's a thing. That happens. You can totally do that. That should be a PvP strategy. You know how hunters can, like, scare beast or whatever? They should be able to tame druids in animal form. And let's say that you can prevent that by switching animal form mid-tame cast. So it's, like, not something that happens all the time, because otherwise that would be ridiculous. You know, have it be as rare as getting a res off in Arena, for example, but oh my goodness, how funny would that be? You just get, not mind controlled, but literally, like, you know, they get, I guess, mind controlled, or I want them to basically behave with pet AI for you for a limited duration of time. The druid was embarrassed about it. I have almost 30 characters in Dalaran already. I want the name. The owner in Dalaran Realm seems to be dead. I see. You can res in Arena? Am I frozen? I look okay. So you can res in Arena. The trick, though, is you can only res when out of combat, and it's like a 10-second cast. Maybe a little less than that, but it's around a 10-second cast. So all somebody has to do to prevent you from resing is get you back in combat. So, like, hit you with a ranged ability, and all of a sudden you can't do it anymore. So it is a thing that will happen sometimes at the end of, like, a 2s match or a 3s match. One team has one kill down, they're just chasing down the rest of them. If nobody's really paying attention, it's not unheard of for the healer of the team that's down a player to, like, hide, like, stealth away, shadow meld, whatever, hide, and then get that res cast off if nobody's paying attention. The thing is, a lot of people will have add-ons that alert various things, and if a res starts going off, the add-on's gonna start telling you about it. So you can almost always stop it, but I've seen it happen. I've seen it done. It's possible. There's no longer an existing NPC that was a tameable worgen. Only time I get reses off was when I'm against that rogue. I haven't tried. I don't try much. I only try when I'm having too much fun. Out of the three zones so far, which one is the best? Kitchen Games, thank you for the 11-month reset. Appreciate it. Also, I don't know if I thank Mandracon for their brand new set. That was a couple minutes ago. I'm sorry I missed that. Thank you. Best zone. That's a really hard thing to say. It's like if somebody showed me... It's completely subjective, right?
like how good a zone is. There, it's basically like deciding which art is your favorite. I can tell you my favorite zone.
Freedom for the masters.
Which is probably a tie between this one and Revendreth, but Bastion was also very good. This one has really Revendreth had fun characters too. I think I just like this one because I like the colors a little better. It's a little brighter. Although not this area is of course a bit gloomy, but Revendreth had the architecture though.
Freedom for the masters.
If you want to be really annoying, spam start the res to ping the enemy constantly. There was some ability that people used to do that with. There was like some heal or whatever that was tagged as a big heal that you could just start over and over and over again. You on beta? Yeah, we're on the Shadowlands Alpha right now. You have the Covenant power. Yeah, I do. I haven't tried it yet. That's a good point. So if I cast this, my next 10 spell casts, my Mind Blast is going to reduce my damage taken. My shield will give me mana. Or 20% resource. I'm assuming that's gonna give me mana and not. Here, let's just use it. So the spells that are gonna trigger this once we've used it, Void Bolt, Powered Shield, and Mind Blast. And Shadow Mend. So let's Shadow Mend. Let's Powered Shield myself. So the shield, I'm getting. So the reduced damage taken does apply to yourself after you Mind Blast. Let's do a Void Bolt. And that's gonna give me, I don't see the buff for that one, I only see the reduced damage taken. The Void Bolt was supposed to reduce the cooldowns of up to 5 allies' major abilities, so maybe it does actually.
My queen, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I guess it does. I wasn't looking. I was looking in the wrong space. I was looking for a buff. I forgot that it was going to reduce my cooldowns. There's just a lot going on with it, yeah? The shield, did it give me insanity? Shadowfree's dream is dead. Maybe for you. The buff was stacking. First time seeing you in stream, just got my invincible. Congratulations. That's such a good feeling to be free of there. I think that's what I like most. it's a little bad, but the thing that I like most about getting mounts to drop is not that I now have a new mount to ride. That has kind of lost its impact because there's just so many mounts in this game now. But it's the fact that I can move on because I wasn't going to give up. I wasn't going to stop running that raid until I got the mount. So it just means I don't have to run that raid anymore. It's not even about the mount these days. What does your shirt say, Hazel? The shirt says Nazoth the Corruptor. The Corruptor's in very fine print. This was a BlizzCon merch shirt from last year. Why do people tell me to get him to play Classic? Get who to play Classic? I've missed something. I've missed some conversation. I think trying to talk anybody into playing any specific game is a bit pointless. Usually people are going to do what they're going to do. Although, maybe if I tried more, I could convince people of things. But then if they don't like it, that's my fault and, ooh, responsibility. I'd rather it be their own fault when they don't like the thing they decided to do. Okay, there's Wagon Master Darrowin. She's having a bad day. Save the anima for the wild seeds. I'm just a wagon master. Don't say that. Sacrifices can be made. I return to the cycle. I mean, they're making a big dramatic deal out of this, but it's the way it sounds, and perhaps I'm misunderstanding. The way it sounds is that the cycle involves being reincarnated. They're just going back to Azeroth. Well, maybe not necessarily Azeroth, I don't know. I know nothing. This is the Heart of the Grove. We have to get it back, of course. Although this is cool. This looks cool. What do you want? Speak with Tizan, of course. Yeah, that's my puppy friend. I need you to use some of your anima. Sorry, I know, tough ask. Hey, he's listening off confirmed. How will they ever fix Shadow Priest? Let's see. Ardenweald looks kind of dark. I mean, the earlier parts were okay. Have you tried Classic? I did try Classic. Hey, Hazel's up, Isolation. Tried Norms if you weren't running them already. Do we know when Shadowlands comes out? No, not yet. We know that it'll be quarter four.
So the last couple of months of 2020, you know, kind of October through December-ish, I would... Oh. Hang on, my camera's out of battery. I forgot that I unplugged it. I need to... Hang on. That's going to turn back on, but it's not going to last very long. Here. Enjoy the dog. One moment, please. Good. I gotta get up again. All right. Oh no. I rolled all the way off the mat. It's kind of hard to get back onto it. Okay. Joker's getting an almost good nap. Let's see. Have a good day, Hazel. Enjoyed watching your videos in YouTube. Thanks, Kate. Let's see. They ruin beautiful zones with corrupt and dark parts. They do this every time. It is true that there's usually somebody's usually up to something. 10 times out of 10, there's a problem and only we can fix it. I suppose they could represent it in a less visually dark way, but then you might not see what the problem was. The veil can't get a rest. It's gonna get a rest, though. Well, actually, that's a good point. I was gonna say after 8.3 ends, but then the assaults are probably gonna continue because people will need to keep farming stuff from them. Oh, you know what it is? It's just, like, you can use the Dormy, right? To put the veil back. Because they took the corruption out of it. It's just got a different problem now. Skater Spanky, thanks for the brand new sub. Welcome to the Squirrel Squad. Why do you love Shadow Priest? I like the resource system, and I also like the themes a lot. I think aesthetically the Lovecraft themes really do it for me. I like the whole kind of creepy, insidious horror, you know, tentacles and spookiness vibe, as opposed to the more outright dark vibes of a class like a Warlock or a Death Knight. What else do I like about it? The insanity is fun. I really enjoy kind of the beat your high score mentality of stretching out void forms within a given raid fight. I like being able to slow fall when I trip off of cliffs. I think he bumped Joker's camera. I just he's shifted. We had to move it to one side last time and now I need to move it back. There we go. How is Shadow in Shadowlands? Nice to see you live. It seems fine. It doesn't seem any different from Shadow Priest much on live. They've made a couple of talent changes, but functionally you don't really live your life much differently. The big thing that you notice when you're playing it on Alpha is that Shadow is just very squishy to level, and that's always been true. If you remember leveling Shadow Priest through Legion, it was rough. As a class, we tend to do better when we aren't tanking stuff directly, or if we do have to tank stuff, we do better when we outgear it a little bit, and we tend to scale just better. We just need a little bit of gear usually, so leveling is always kind of tough, but you know, it doesn't last forever. Time is it? 4:59. Do you have a favorite plushie? Love your collection. The alpaca baby that I think was the most recent one is pretty good. Dolly's pretty good. I'm off. Thanks for an awesome stream, Hazel. Have a great day, chat. See you later, Workskin. Get your wife some potatoes. Can you still use Void Bolt while mind flaying? Yes, but... Yes, actually. I was going to say I don't have that passive yet, but it looks like I do. I just haven't remembered that I have that passive yet. And then, oh man, but I plugged you in. you know what? I am out of time, actually. It is about time for me, and I do have more editing to do today. So maybe this is just where our time together ends. I will be back tomorrow. Thank you very much for watching my stream. I'll be back tomorrow afternoon. Tomorrow is Thursday. That's a true fact. Maybe I'll have tried out the air fryer. Maybe I'll be able to tell you what I think of it so far. Appreciate you guys. Thank you so much for a great stream. Sorry it's ending with like two black squares. That's kind of weird, but what do you do? Appreciate you guys, and I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day.